original.
Check.
Thank you.
evening. Welcome to the second show of the first United States solo tour of Glenn Hughes. And my fabulous cohorts from the West Coast. It's really great to see everybody. I got a lot of people here that I know. A lot of my wife's friends are here. A lot of my fans from across the country are here. Amongst those from Virginia and Washington and everywhere else. And I want to thank you for your support over the years of my music, from Trapeze to Deep Purple to Sabbath to Youth Thrall to my solo work and ongoing. I make music because I love it, and I make music for you. I make music that I think is appropriate for my soul, and I hope you dig it. I want to do a song that I wrote and performed with Purple. It's called Might Just Take Your Life.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. It sounds like Elvis, right? Thank you very much.
Elvis! Chappie!
I got more than I asked for. I'm going to do a song that I have a new album out called Return of Crystal Karma. That is the biggest selling Glenn Hughes solo album in Europe and Japan, and it's your turn to get in the mood. I want to say that I've never toured America solo, and it's time to start. You may ask me why I haven't. It's for personal reasons I can't get into, contractual things, and it's time to start now. It starts now. But I want to thank my genuine love for my fans over the years that have supported me through the dark period. Thank you. And I want to thank all the great singers that came before me to introduce me to this wonderful world that I live in, that I can give back to you what they gave to me. This is a song I wrote with Tony Iommi on my new album. It is called Gone.
Dream, I have a mind, old vision.
Thank you so much. Gone just like the last. I'd love to do that. I think you might be too funky. You know, I want to do another new song. I wouldn't say it's a new song, it's a solo song. It's a song I wrote with Stevie Salas. And this is off The Way It Is. And I love this track. It's called You Kill Me.
This is a slamming fucking song. Stevie Salas.
Just in case you didn't know it, I don't write songs about goblins and weasels and demons and fucking all that shit. I write about the human condition. I write about what goes on in me, and I know what goes on in you. So I want you to read into it what you feel. I know the thing about the video thing is that when it came in the 80s, kind of ruined the mystique.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. Give me a second. Just one more. Hey, Dave, can you try it for me, would you? I'm just gonna check something out, okay? Hello. I couldn't hear the repeat, Jerry. I'm sorry, man. It's good water. Check. That's better. You know what it is? I can't really hear the repeat at all. Check. It's very dull. Anyway, you're not supposed to know about that. Anyway, when I was 18 years old, I was... Take it off now, Dad. Put it back on, I'm singing. Okay, just leave it there. I was 18 years old and I was fortunate to sit in my mother's kitchen and write... I think a lot of songwriters are going to tell you this. Whether you listen to them on the telly or if you listen to them in your mother's kitchen. But I got a chance to write a couple of songs that day, one of them being the next song. It was this moment I realized that maybe my job in life was to carry the message of music to people across the planet. And this is a song that's been with me for a long, long time, and if you're a real Glenn fan, you'll know the song is Coast to Coast. Thank you.
To the bottom.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
You're the man!
Thank you so much. I just want to say something that's very important to me. That you know, before I joined Deep Purple, which was amazing, amazing format for any young musician to take, the reason they asked me to join was they saw this group that I just played a song by, and I thought it was very, very adventurous of them to think that I could bring something new to the table. But the forum that you just seen at the last song is basically where I came from. Basically, I've been playing funk music since I was 5 years old.
Get it, baby!
And I'm white as a ghost over here. But you know something? It takes all kinds, and I'm just truly blessed. I'm truly blessed to be here tonight. And I'm going to do a song that I wrote in 1970. Yes, folks, I am 39 years old. That means I wrote the song when I was 4.
Talented bastard, aren't you?
I'm a talented son of a twitch. So this is a song, this is the title track of the first album I ever signed lead vocals on. And this is a little story about John Bonham, my old friend from Led Zeppelin, who has passed away, you know. He's a really good friend of mine, and he used to pick me up at my house, and he used to come and watch my band Trapeze play when Zeppelin were off the road. And this is a song that he demanded he play on himself. So this is John Bonham's favorite song, and John Bonham is in the house tonight. So this is for you, Bonzo. It's called Medusa.
Yeah.
Thank you.
gracias, señores and señoritas. I have had a wonderful evening. My guitar player, on the other hand, Georgie Nastos from the Bronx. Big hand for George. George has been with me for 5 years. He's the funk bank, he's the funk guy, and also he's a very rock guy. George seems to have problems with bleeding fingers. Now, this isn't The Who, for Christ's sake. This is Glenn Hughes and his funky trio. What, I'm gonna give you a fucking banana or something over there? What's going on over there, Georgie? I love my friend George. Unzip a banana. I think George is having a bit of a problem, but I'm gonna do a dance for you. We're gonna do a Glenn Hughes staple. The song I wrote with Tommy, Come Taste the Band is the Come Taste the Band was an album that moved the band into a new era. 1976 was the year I was 7 years old. 7. And I love the funk.
Get tighter.
If you don't like the funk, can't help you. It takes a special kind of guy to have the funk. If you don't have the funk, then guess what? Can't shout good. My wife likes the funk. My wife likes the funk. She's Mrs. Funk, I'm Mr. Funk. Here's a song called Getting Tighter. We'll be right back. I want to thank you all for coming out tonight. Thank you all for staying out late tonight. I know it's past my bedtime, and I'm not joking. You know, I normally bed by 9:30, and that's not a joke. In the morning. I'm gonna close with a song I wrote with David Coverdale. And this is another moment in my career that was a beautiful thing. I wrote this song, and this is the first song that David and I wrote. We wrote it on the beach in the northeast of England, the day he joined Deep Purple. And this is a song we didn't record for 3 years, and it's a Glenn Hughes and David Coverdale moment. It's called You Keep On Moving. And I want to wish David all the very best. We've connected spiritually. It's a beautiful thing. More importantly, I'd like to wish you all the very best in life. Keep coming back. Keep it simple. Walk the path. Life is good. If you really want to be, I see you.
got a kid.
Afterwards, if you want. It's important for me to connect with my fans that have stood by me through all this God stuff. I love you all. Thank you so much for coming. I'll see you in about 5 or 10 minutes, all right?
Plum Patrol!
I think you know this one. So 10 million copies. Thank you very much. I love you. It's George Nestos on guitar, and I am Papa. You can call me Papa. Welcome to the second show of the first United States solo tour of Glenn Hughes. And my fabulous cohorts from the West Coast. It's really great to see everybody. I got a lot of people here that I know. A lot of my wife's friends are here. A lot of my fans from across the country are here. Amongst those from Virginia and Washington and everywhere else. And I want to thank you for your support over the years of my music, from Trapeze to Deep Purple to Sabbath to Youth Thrall, to my solo work and ongoing. I make music because I love it, and I make music for you. I make music that I think is appropriate for my soul, and I hope you dig it. I want to do a song that I wrote and performed with Purple. It's called Might Just Take Your Life.
Thank you.
That's that sound like Elvis, right? Thank you very much.
Elvis! Trapeze!
I got more than I asked for. I'm gonna do a song that I have a new album out called Return of Crystal Karma. That is the biggest selling Glenn Hughes solo album in Europe and Japan, and it's your turn to get in the mood. And it's, you know, I want to say that I've never toured America solo, and it's time to start. You may ask me why I haven't. It's for personal reasons I can't get into, contractual things, and it's time to start now. It starts now. But I want to thank my genuine love for my fans over the years that have supported me through the dark period. Thank you. And I want to thank all the great singers that came before me to introduce me to this wonderful world that I live in, that I can give back to you what they gave to me. This is a song I wrote with Tony Iommi on my new album. It is called Gone.
Dream, I have a mind on vision.
Thank you so much. Gone just like the last. I love to do that. I think you might be too funky. You know, I want to do another new song. I wouldn't say it's a new song, it's a solo song. It's a song I wrote with Stevie Salas.
And
this is off The Way It Is. And I love this track. It's called You Kill Me.
This is a slamming fucking song. Stevie Salas. Just in case you didn't know it, I don't write songs about goblins and weasels and demons and fucking all that shit. I write about the human condition. I write about what goes on in me, and I know what goes on in you. So I want you to read into it what you feel. And you know, the thing about the video thing is when it came in the 80s, kind of ruined the mystique. You're not tonight. Thank you so much. Give me a second. Just one more. Hey, Dave, can you try it for me, would you? I'm just gonna check something out, okay? Hello. I couldn't hear the repeat, Jerry. I'm sorry, man. It's good water. Check. That's better. You know what it is? I can't really hear the repeat at all. Check. It's very dull. Anyway, you're not supposed to know about that. Anyway, when I was 18 years old, I was take it off now, Dad. I'm putting back on what I'm singing. Okay, let's do it. I was 18 years old and I was fortunate to sit in my mother's kitchen and write. I think a lot of songwriters are going to tell you this. Whether you listen to them on the telly or if you listen to them in your mother's kitchen, but I got a chance to write a couple of songs that day, one of them being the next song. It was this moment I realized that maybe my job in life was to carry the message of music to people across the planet. And this is a song that's been with me for a long, long time, and if you're a real Glenn fan, you'll know the song is Coast to Coast.
Yeah.
you very much. Very much it is a love thing, you know. It's all from here. It ain't from here, it's from here. And I'm going to do, I can't see her, but you know, I told the New Jersey audience last night, my manager said to me, you know, because I normally play with my glasses on because I'm blind as a bat. And I normally wear blue glasses, but they look like they're, you know, dark glasses. And he said, if you do that in you know, this part of the world, they think you're like a superstar or something. So I don't wear my glasses, but I can't see anything! I can't see the set list. So I just have to resort to being a normal guy tonight. I'm over here, George. I'm going to turn up the funk. This is what my fans want on the website. We want the funk. Jim Wilson wants the funk. It's called Way Back to the Bone. Song from 1972. Thank you.
evening. Welcome to the second show of the first United States solo tour of Glenn Hughes. And my fabulous cohorts from the West Coast. It's really great to see everybody. I got a lot of people here that I know. A lot of my wife's friends are here. A lot of my fans from across the country are here. Amongst those from Virginia and Washington and everywhere else. And I want to thank you for your support over the years of my music, from Trapeze to Deep Purple to Sabbath to Youth Thrall, to my solo work and ongoing. I make music because I love it, and I make music for you. I make music that I think is appropriate for my soul, and I hope you dig it. I want to do a song that I wrote and performed with Purple. It's called Might Just Take Your Life.
Thank you.
like Elvis, but thank you very much.
Elvis! Chappie!
I got more than I asked for. I'm gonna do a song that I have a new album out called Return of Crystal Karma. That is the biggest selling Glenn Hughes solo album in Europe and Japan, and it's your turn to get in the mood. And it's, you know, I want to say that I've never toured America solo, and it's time to start. You may ask me why I haven't. It's for personal reasons I can't get into, contractual things, and it's time to start now. It starts now. But I want to thank my genuine love for my fans over the years that have supported me through the dark period. Thank you. And I want to thank all the great singers that came before me to introduce me to this wonderful world that I live in, that I can give back to you what they gave to me. This is a song I wrote with Tony Iommi on my new album. It is called Gone.
Dream, I have a mind, oh, vision.
best. I love to do that. I think you might be too funky. You know, I want to do another new song. I wouldn't say it's a new song, it's a solo song. It's a song I wrote with Stevie Salas. And this is off The Way It Is. And I love this track. It's called You Kill Me.
This is a slamming fucking song. Stevie Salas. Just in case you didn't know it, I don't write songs about goblins and weasels and demons and fucking all that shit. I write about the human condition. I write about what goes on in me, and I know it goes on in you.
So I want you to read into it what you feel. And you know the thing about the video thing is when it came in the 80s, kind of ruined the mystique. very much. Thank you so much. Give me a second. Just one more. Hey, Dave, can you try it for me, would you? I'm just gonna check something out, okay? Hello. I couldn't hear the repeat, Jerry. I'm sorry, man. It's good water. Check.
That's better. You know what it is? I can't really hear the repeat at all.
Check.
It's very dull. Anyway, you're not supposed to know about that.
Anyway, when I was 18 years old, I was...
Take it off now, Dad.
Put it back on, I'm singing. Okay, just leave it there. I was 18 years old and I was fortunate to sit in my mother's kitchen and write... I think a lot of songwriters are going to tell you this. Whether you listen to them on the telly or if you listen to them in your mother's kitchen. But I got a chance to write a couple of songs that day, one of them being the next song. It was this moment I realized that maybe my job in life was to carry the message of music to people across the planet. And this is a song that's been with me for a long, long time, and if you're a real Glenn fan, you'll know the song is Coast to Coast.
Yeah. Thank you.